Bismillah. As you know that we learn the time and the place where Prophet peace be upon him was born, and we also know the name of his father Abdullah, and we know that he died several weeks before the birth of Prophet. Now here, next session, we have to know about his other family members and his wife. His mother, Amna binti Wahab, died when Prophet, peace be upon him, was 6 years old. So my dear students, you can imagine that before Prophet birth, his father died. And when he was only 6 years, just like a small kid, his mother also died. So his father, so he was raised by his grandfather, okay, till the age of 8. Later, his uncle Abu Talib raised him. So you can imagine that the difficulties and the life of Prophet, how started from the how started in the struggle. So here we know two things. Number one, the struggle comes in the life of Prophet, peace be upon him, not as you can say that to Allah, because Allah loves his Prophet and he don't want to make him in any difficulties, but Allah going to make him more strong and strong. Okay, so after his mother, then his grandfather start to grow up, and after his grandfather, his uncle named Abu Talib start to raise him, or you can say that he lived with his uncle. Then we move to the next part of the lesson. Growing up, and with the exception of Aisha, when Prophet, peace be upon him, start to growing up, here the writer mentioned that except Aisha, she is the wife of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, only married widows or divorced women. What it mean? Except Aisha, okay? Only Aisha, the wife of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he married all other ladies or women who divorced or widows. What it mean? What is the mean by widow? Okay, it's very easy to understand. After marriage, if the husband of a lady is died, that lady name as widow. Okay, my dear. And what is the meaning of divorce? It means that if after marriage, the couple, husband and wife, separate according to the rules and according to the Islam rules, and they are not more in relation, this word is named as divorce. And people also in Arab or in Arabic, I think this word is used as talak or talak or like this. I can't pronounce it well, this one. So till here, if my dear, you have any question, you can raise your hand. Otherwise, type no. Hurry up. Till here, if you have any question, you can raise your hand. Otherwise, type no in the chat quickly. Then I move next. Hurry up. Well done, Salman bin Sultan. Nawaf, very good. Muhammad, excellent. Great. Okay. Now, my dear students, this time I'm going to send you a link. Okay. So everyone just try to open this link and then we move to the next part of the lesson here. Okay. So that is the link that I'm going to send you. Please everyone open this link. When you going to open this link, the window will pop up in front of you. Is that one? Yes. Now here the lesson that we started, and we know about the life of Prophet and about the marriages, about his mother, about his father. So that is very important part of Prophet, peace be upon him. All his wives were either widows or divorced, except for Aisha. And the reason are why Prophet, peace be upon him, married with other ladies, with other women. They are mostly widows or divorced, and their husbands are died. They are alone. Their kids, nobody going to help them for food and for survive. But Prophet, peace be upon him, took that responsibility, and they married these kinds of women. Number one reason, helping out the widows, creating family bonds. Different clan spread his messages, increasing his credibility by giving his women the opportunities to teach about him and his private life. Now, I'm going to take back you on your textbook. So you can see this page here. These are the reasons behind Prophet Muhammad's, peace be upon him, marriages. Okay, what it mean? You are a student. Why you are going to study the books? Why you are going to learn the things? Reason. The reason is that you want to know, you want to learn, you want to get a good job, you want to get money after the job, you want to make yourself as a good citizen everywhere in the world, not only in KSA or not only in Yemen or not only in America, everywhere in the world. So the knowledge will going to help you. You should know about the betterment of your future. You should know about each and everything and what is good for your life. So these are the reasons behind the marriages of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Till here, if anyone have any question, so please, he can raise his hand. Till here, if you have any question, my dear, please raise your hand. Otherwise, type no in the chat. Hurry up quickly. And the students, they just joined the meeting. Student, they just joined the meeting. Please open the link and you read about this. Yes, I can see here one hand. That is Abdullah. Yes, sir. Yes, my dear. Please, now you can speak.
Mr.
Yes, my dear.
Go Google and I do not come for Allah and Muhammad. I want to see what is that, because I want to tell you. You tell us that homework, no come anything.
How everybody knows. Go and search again, write capital A dot and capital D. That is your assignment, my dear. You should try again. Okay, that is just like a homework. Okay. Thank you very much, Abdurrahman. Thank you, my dear. Your comments and your things are very highly appreciated for me. Thank you very much. It's mean